Hello! This short video shows how to build a temperature sensor that will alert you by text or email if the temperature in your home gets too cold. Motivation for the project is the large amount of damage a frozen pipe can cause. In the case shown here, the heat was shut off, but the water was on. The sink froze and ruptured during a cold snap. Water from the broken sink sprayed onto the ceiling, freezing, and forming a large mass of ice that pulled down part of the building. The property was demolished due to the large amount of damage. This is an example of the text messages that the device sends. A notice indicates a routine daily test of the system. An alert indicates the temperature is too cold. Your phone can be set up to make the text messages from the device loud to wake you up so you don't miss an important alert. I looked at using a $120 Nest thermostat to send a low temperature alarm, but ran into two problems. The first is that the Nest thermostat must be hooked up to a 24-volt AC furnace control system and an associated relay to harvest power for its rechargeable batteries and for Wi-Fi. I didn't want to replace my thermostat and wanted an independent alarm system. I was able to use this Granger transformer relay, part 6AZH6, for $22.22 to provide a transformer and relay to get the Nest thermostat to work, but ran into a second issue. The second problem I had with the Nest thermostat was getting it to send a temperature notification to the Nest Home application on my phone. I tried everything I could find on the internet to configure the app, but I couldn't get it to work. The option was expensive at $120, so I took the Nest thermostat back to Best Buy and tried something else. There are home monitoring systems that would provide temperature alerts, but most have costly devices and require monthly monitoring fees. I decided to try a $27.50 Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi with a $1.60 TMP36 temperature sensor from SparkFun. Setting up the temperature sensing hardware was an easy soldering job. I had trouble getting accurate temperature readings that appear to be partly due to high impedance resistance on the Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi analog input pins. I think the high resistance prevented voltage from draining off the sensing pin and caused a reading that was 10 to 15 degrees higher than actual. Adding a 16,000 ohm resistor across the sense pin and ground resolved most of the problem. The sensor still read 6.5 degrees too high based on comparison with a Fluke 52 thermometer. So I added a correction factor in code. I noticed some variability in the readings, so the program takes an average of 500 readings. This is overkill, but the program has plenty of time with the simple program. Looking at the pin side of the TMP36 temperature sensor with the flat face up, the left pin is positive and connected to the 5-volt pin on the Arduino using a red wire as shown. The center and right pin are connected together with a 16,000 ohm resistor I had laying around. A larger resistance would work. I would be cautious about using less resistance because the draw on the output pin might be more than the sensor is rated for. The right pin is connected to the Arduino ground with a black wire. The center pin is the sensor output and connected to pin A0 with a purple wire. The code is available in the comments and performs the following actions. Sets up variables, connects to Wi-Fi, and sets the real-time clock first. Every minute, it checks the temperature and the time. At 9 a.m., it updates the real-time clock because the clock drifts about 15 minutes each day on the Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi board. At noon, it sends a notice with the current temperature as a test to verify the system is working. If the temperature is below 50 degrees, the program sends an alarm that the temperature is low. The system is set to wait 15 minutes between messages to prevent spam. The system will send updates every 15 minutes until the temperature rises above 50 degrees. There are a couple of things to be aware of when setting up a Wi-Fi connection. First is that the Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi requires a 2.4 gigahertz router. One system I tested had the 5 and 2.4 gigahertz bands named separately, so I selected the 2.4 gigahertz band. Another system I tested used a Calix Gigaspire combination modem and router, which had only one band listed. This is apparently a combined band. I was concerned that a combined band might cause issues if the router tried to communicate with the Arduino on a 5 gigahertz band. So I went into the router setup and configured a separate 2.4 gigahertz band using the online help for the router. Security for the Wi-Fi connection will depend on how your router is configured. One system I tested uses a Linksys router with MAC filtering and no password. I turned off the MAC filtering for a moment, then found the Arduino MAC address by checking to see what new device connects with the Arduino board turned on and attempting to connect. I add that MAC address to the list and re-enable MAC filtering security. There is a note in the code on how to modify the command line for this type of security. The other system I tested required a password, which may be more common, and there's a comment in the code on how to set this up too. I had to set an application password on the Gmail account I use to send the emails. Gmail limits to 500 emails per day, which is more than enough for my needs, and the service is free. Setting it up is easy with a search like Gmail, how to set up an application password. I had difficulty getting the time to configure using the config time NPT server line utilizing the ESP mail client library, but was able to get the mail time set using the NTP client.h library. To power the project, both a wall wart and USB work well. One system I tested, I used a barrel jack and a 5-volt wall wart I had laying around. On the other system I tested, I used a spare USB charger with a USB-C adapter to power the Arduino board. Both worked well. I had some challenges getting the code stable and setting things up in routines. I'm not a coder, but thanks to the quality examples people post, I was able to get things to work. There are plenty of opportunities to improve my code, and I welcome suggestions. I use global variables too much, and the libraries are more sophisticated than I pretend to understand, but I hope my example might be useful to some experimenters. I'll walk you through the code for the rest of the video.
The first section of code adds four libraries, RTC for the real-time clock, NTP client to access the national time protocol servers, Wi-Fi S3 to access the Wi-Fi card, and ESP mail client to send email and text messages. The next block sets global variables to measure temperature and run the main program loop. The alarm temperature is set on line 14 to 50 degrees Fahrenheit, which you may want to change. The next couple lines set up some variables needed for the NTP client. Lines 26 through 35 need to be modified to reflect your Wi-Fi and Gmail account parameters. The last block on the page sets up some parameters for the RTC and email libraries that you won't need to change. Wi-Fi Connect on line 43 is a function that connects to your Wi-Fi. You may need to change line 45 as noted in the comment, depending on if you need a password or not for your Wi-Fi. Set RRTC time on line 55 updates the internal real-time clock on the Arduino Uno R4 Wi-Fi board. This gets called on startup and again once a day to keep the clock accurate. It drifts about 15 minutes per day, which is bad because you might start getting notices in the middle of the night. Get temp on line 68 measures the temperature 500 times and takes an average. It also adds a calibration factor to the raw reading that equates to subtracting 6.5 Fahrenheit from the raw reading. Setup email on line 80 builds your email, including to, from, subject, and text. I added the IP address to the user domain on line 86. It used to be blank, like line 85. I have seen it both ways in online examples. I was having some crashes, and the comment indicated to me that I might need the IP. I wasn't sure, but I tried it, and it seems better. You might want to change line 98 to reflect your location being measured. Send email on line 105 tries to send the message. I added line 106 because I was seeing some handshake issues with the email server that was crashing the Arduino. This, with the change on line 86, seemed to cure the crash. Setup on line 134 connects to Wi-Fi and updates the real-time clock initially. Loop on line 146 runs every minute and checks the temperature and schedules emails. First, it measures the temperature, checks the time, and calculates the number of minutes since it last sent an email. On line 151, the program compares the current hour with when it is supposed to update the clock. If it is time, the program connects to Wi-Fi, gets and sets the time, then disconnects from Wi-Fi. There is a flag to track the daily time update that gets reset earlier in the morning. Similar logic is used to send the daily notification starting on line 159. Logic on line 165 tests if the temperature is low and an alert needs to be sent. In both cases, the send message flag is set to true to indicate a message needs to be sent. If the send message flag is true, line 167 sends a message once it has been 15 minutes since the last message. The 15-minute limit prevents too many spam emails, but I want to know if the situation is getting better in case I have to travel to a location to resolve an issue. I don't want to drive an hour and a half if the situation is resolved. The rest of the code is a callback routine that prints email status that I didn't materially modify. Attribution to some of the sites I relied on more for this project, and a license that carries with this modified code. Thanks for watching, and I hope you find it useful.